This video is brought to you by The Face of Boxing 275K from EA Sports. It's in the game. Build your boxer's profile by knocking out bum after bum after bum. Get access to hundreds of catchphrases such as Bomb Squad and Strap Season. Unlock many other favorite catchphrases, such as "Till this day." Try out our new "The Head Is Not Meant to Be Hit" mode, where you don't even box. You just downgrade the competition of the other boxers in your division. You build on your social media, clout chase, and the best of all, start charging for pay-per-views that have no business being on pay-per-view. Try out the newest franchise from EA Sports.
EA Sports. It's in the game.
To this day!
You can't fuck with Red Glove on his worst day. How about this?
I ain't really changed. It's the same old rebel. Still a radical. I'm passionate. It's just another level. AT told me I should fight back. They don't like that. Just know if you rock the boat, you better have a life raft. BJ told me I should fight back. They don't like that.
What up, everybody in the YTBC? Big shout out to the UGC, hashtag Combat the Boxing, and the MBBC. When you get a chance, go to the description box of this video. I put the links to all my brothers there. Please give them a listen, and if you feel compelled to do so, please subscribe. Now, a couple days ago, I did release a video where I talked about the numbers that were released by Rick Glaser and my thoughts on those numbers pertaining to Deontay Wilder and his star power. Now, I didn't just want to talk about the lowest numbers. Well, first off, those weren't even the lowest numbers that were reported. The 2,500 was. I already said I think that was a troll. Some people feel it was a misprint, which could very well be. They could have meant to put in an extra zero, which would have made it 250K, which brings it closer to the last numbers that were reported. Now, I'm going to be honest, I don't really know who they were reported by, but I'm hearing that the pay-per-view of Wilder versus Ortiz 2 actually did 275,000 pay-per-view buys. Now, that is substantially more than what Rick Glaser reported. Now, my understanding is that Rick Glaser's reports also did not include streaming from gaming consoles and other streaming devices. So, you know, that you could probably expect some kind of inflation from that number. Now, I wouldn't have expected it to go all the way to 275, but I mean, if that's the number, that's the number. Like I said originally, I'm not looking to push an anti or pro Wilder agenda with these numbers. I really just want the real numbers. And unfortunately, when it comes to pay-per-view, we may not actually ever know what the real numbers are. Not only for this fight, but really for any fight. You know, there's so many things that are not taken into account for. All we can do is go by the numbers that are reported and try to give our best assessment from those numbers. All right. So let's, for this video, let's forget about the 138K. Let's talk about the 275K. Now, that does exceed the expectations that I had. I had somewhere between 100,000 to 200,000, being 275,000. That is almost 100K more than what I thought. So in that regard, I got to give credit where credit is due. I think if that is the real number, or if it's around there, then I would say that he is a bigger star than I thought. Now, although 275 is substantially bigger than the 138, it's still nowhere near the 800,000 to a million pay-per-view buys that certain people were trying to push was going to happen. 275 is better than 138. Doesn't take a mathematician to come up to that surmise. But you're not going to push this man down my throat telling me that he is the face of boxing if he did 275. Because if he did 275, that's not that much less than the 325 that he did with Fury. And I have to say that is somewhat impressive. I did not think he would be able to sell that with Luis Ortiz. However, to put in perspective, it's not anywhere near the million. It's not. It's a lot closer to 138 than it is to a million. We can be 100 about that, right? The reality is this. He's not this big megastar in the States with this 275 number. The pay-per-view market is dying, but even in that dying market, Manny Pacquiao was able to pull 500,000. So why don't y'all just say he's the face of boxing? Or you can stop fucking around and just be honest with yourself. You really like Deontay Wilder, and there's nothing wrong with that, but he's not the face of boxing. Some of my favorite boxers are not the face of boxing, and I have no problem with it. Because I have no emotional attachments to these guys. When somebody says that they don't like Lomachenko, I'm not like, well, why don't you like Lomachenko? No, I you don't like Lomachenko, that's perfectly fine. You have the right to like and dislike whatever boxer you want to. And I'm not gonna be up your ass about it. But a lot of these fans, or I should say these fanboys, they can't accept the fact that you don't like the fighter that they like. Imagine if you did this shit with Coke and Pepsi, with McDonald's and Burger King, with Nike and Adidas. It would look fucking ridiculous. Well, guess what? It still looks fucking ridiculous. Just be men. Be adults. Sorry, I shouldn't say men because there's women who watch the sport too. Just be adults. Be adults about this shit. I like who I like. You like who you like. It doesn't mean that we can't be friends. A lot of these people, they just have this gang mentality that if you're not with us, if you're not with us, you're against us. And that's bullshit. This isn't that serious. It is a sport. It is to be for fun. And a lot of y'all have sucked the fun right out of that shit. To all my subscribers, anybody watching my videos, or you just so happy to stumble upon this video, hope y'all have a wonderful, blessed day. Peace. Undefeated.